is a problem of reconciliation. It is a problem of political nature. It is a problem of conflict and the structure of conflict. And addressing that more conflict is not the appropriate means. Addressing it is basically pragmatic wisdom, understanding of the problem, and then looking at the character of the actors and how all these actors can be brought to the negotiating table, and you have to understand their respective interests. But today, what, you know, if you look at Afghanistan, fortunately I have studied for some time, 16 years, internally you look at it has a character of civil conflict, and in that civil conflict, a government system has been formulated where the power of Afghanistan by an external power has been handed over to the elements that have been pushed to a corner of Afghanistan in 98 towards the end of the Taliban rule. But I think the problem is war itself, and the problem is that how to, the problem is this intellectual policy and strategic incompetence and inability or willingness to come to terms with this conflict itself and structure of itself. The language, the symbolism, and the policy prescriptions that we hear are basically in terms of this warring group and that warring group and this state. It's not that state and an insurgency, it's much deeper into the where the problem is. I think the problem, what creates trouble in US-Pakistan relationship is locating this problem. Pakistan locates this problem in American policy, in the debris that fell over all entire society and territory of Afghanistan, of the anti-Soviet war, and in Pakistan. The problem that we look at is the problem of the character of the Afghan state in the post-bomb nation and state building process in that country, and also the problem that visualizes Afghanistan altogether a state which is just like Pakistan, or just like other state. Look at Afghanistan very different. There is a problem. I look at Afghanistan in my book that was referred to Recovering the 20th State. What is the meaning of the 20th state? It's one of the few states in the world, and maybe the only state in the world, which has lump elements of ethnicities that constitute a state. Majority of the ethnicities have their own state, or they are two-thirds of the Pashtuns happen to be in Pakistan. Rajasthan, Punjab, and head of Pashtunkhwa. And then go back to it. I'm sorry I'm taking more time and just giving you this historical reference. For me it is very important how Afghanistan state came to be a state as a buffer, and therefore its territories, what are natural territories? We don't know. The natural territories in the pre-colonial age were the territories, as many territories as you could conquer. Kingdoms were based on conquest. They expanded, they shrank, they disappeared, and all those things happened. So therefore, the problem here is, what role really, there was reference in the morning to great game, I don't buy that concept though, but the problem here is about the character of Afghanistan. And here, from Pakistan's point of view, Pakistan, Afghanistan has the same security legacies and the problems that British India had, they were rather magnified in terms of the consequences, in terms of movement of population, in terms of radical ideas and ideologies, and of course the conflict party as well that I'm referring to. The problem from our side is that if Afghanistan is occupied by a state that is hostile to Pakistan's interests, Pakistan inevitably will have a counter-strategy. That is what defines Pakistan's response well before President Ronald Reagan was elected, well before a real relationship between Pakistan's second strategic partnership between the United States and Pakistan was shaped. We were there in Afghanistan since 1975. And of course, we saw at that time, right or wrong, policies are made in the objective environment at a given point of time. At that particular point of time, our strategy was the Soviet occupation, Soviet penetration into the inner structure of the Afghan state, which we knew was taking place in late 60s and early 70s, was going to be difficult for Pakistan to pose a major threat. So we responded. A consistent doctrine, I think, that is going to stay for future is this, that Afghanistan and that area is a strategic backyard for Pakistan. Strategic backyard in the sense that sometimes we talk about strategic depth and all that. It's very defensive. Yes, in the views of many, that strategic depth is that we take our strategic assets, the military, the components, everything, we move into Afghanistan. It's very difficult to move even a refrigerator inside Afghanistan to the forest border. You can't move a strategic force or forces and sustain yourself. If you lose out in your own country, you cannot fight for your survival in another country. I think that is a stupid interpretation. What is important for me is that territory must be denied to a hostile power which uses Afghanistan's territory for any subversion, for any intrusion, for any intervention, for any conflict, for any destabilization inside Pakistan. Where is the problem? I don't think that we have, United States is that problem. United States has another state in Pakistan. The problem is, and that has become very explicit in the August 21st speech and what has been said afterwards, and that is that the 4 hours and one less. But the 4 hours are to reinforce, realign, regionalize, and reconcile, and then assess a step. You know, for us, this realign and regionalize has certain serious implications. And that basically, for Pakistan's long-term, short-term, and of course, if you look at the structure of our state culture, security thinking, defense policy for the last 70 years, if Afghanistan becomes a place where India can play games against Pakistan, that is something that would create problems to Pakistan and the United States. I think in a very polite, diplomatic language, there has been communication between Pakistan and the United States on that issue. But then, here is a big divergence about what role India can play or should play between US and Pakistan. But I think that should not be lightly dismissed. What are the Pakistani concerns? That it is a passive force, it is in development, it is with Afghan government's consent, and Afghanistan is a sovereign state, so therefore, your case is dismissed. In the light of past 70 years, and what I said about the character of Afghanistan, I think it's an extremely important issue that where we have differences, when locating the problem. What can be done about the problem? I think I have to wind up. The problem, what can be done about the problem is simple, but not so simple. Simple is we can say that why is it that Afghan Taliban and why the United States does not talk to the Taliban? We believe that this is Pakistani position and with my position, I am close representing the government side. My position is that there are a number of reconciliations that have to take place in order to settle a country. What can be done? One, at the larger level, it seems that reconciliation has to be between Taliban and the government. But when you get to this issue, Americans would say that, no, we can't directly talk to the Taliban. You push them to talk to the Afghan government. No, this is something which needs to be done, how it had to be done, and how consistent we had to be. I think we were making progress, and the incident of Mullah Mansoor happened. And when I talked to some of my American friends, why did you do it? The answer was that, no, he was the obstruction to a negotiated settlement, therefore we had to win the job. So what has the progress after him? One important thing, I think, what can be done is some kind of understanding between Pakistan and the United States on how, when, where, at what forum we have to integrate the Afghan Taliban into a negotiation process, excluding the government. But again, within Afghanistan, there is a need for reconciliation. It is intra-ethnic, the reconciliation between the Northern Front, but the way and the Taliban as well, and where I believe that Afghan government itself can play a very important role. And also what can be done, I think it's very important that how we can isolate India-Pakistan government conflict from influencing the peace process and stability in all the areas. And also needs to be to conclude, I would say that there are a number of evidences, and I have no time to talk about the Haqqani and the safe havens. I think that's very, let me just say two words. That is something very serious, and it seems to be consistent for the last 6-7 years. And Americans are very serious about this. When I look at this, the statement of comms that has been given to Pakistan during the past 16, 17 years, since 2014, I think we conclude that together, 3-4 years, more than 1 billion of coalition support funds have been withheld because no waiver could be granted. It means that Americans have credible evidence and they strongly believe that there are safe havens inside Pakistan, and this is we are going to see some important fundamental change either both on Pakistan side as well as on the American side, that this issue needs to be resolved. I don't think that any kind of ambiguity is going to work, and the relations between the countries are going to stay as they have been during the last 6 and 7 years. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Reese.